Monday morning, and we're at the Kelly family supercross track here in Manifee. It's pretty amazing. This place is just down the street from our office. That's not right. Hashtag Bronco ambassador, isn't it?
Team Bronco ambassador.
Team Bronco ambassador.
Hashtag ad.
Let me see this thing, dude.
Sick.
Do your job and ambassador here. I'm helping give you a platform.
It's the V6 EcoBoost.
Ooh.
It's got great power. Actually, I've been using it to prep the tracks when they're a little overwatered, kind of like they are today, but I think she'll dry out with the heat.
Well, you're wheel packing with the vehicle?
Yeah, I just go out there, and if the track's not groomed, I kind of drive over the berm and then throw in reverse and drag the front end down the turns, and it packs them in real good.
Did you choose this gray?
I didn't actually chose white.
Because you wanted to be like the modern OJ?
Yeah, I did actually. And then I got this, but this gray is kind of cool.
Yeah.
So, and then KMC hooked me up with some wheels.
Oh, nice.
Some real beadlocks, too.
How did you come in touch with Team Bronco?
They reached out to me.
Really?
Yeah, like March of 2020.
That's sick.
And I was supposed to get it, like, yeah, around then. I was supposed to be like, oh, you'll get it in a month. I didn't think it was real. But, yeah, it ended up being a real thing. And then with the pandemic and, like, the shortage on
vehicles,
ECUs and vehicles, and then they had a recall on the hard top, so that's all fixed now. It took 2.5 years. I didn't think it was actually gonna happen, but it did. I love this thing.
You're teammates with Rachel Strait.
I am. Rachel Strait, a couple other mountain bikers, some fly fishermen and overlanders. No, it's sick. It's a cool group of guys. We got to go it's called Bronco Off Rodeo. Uh-huh. Anybody can sign up and do it. It's rad. They brought us out there. The closest one to us is in Vegas, but there's like four all around the country, and it's sick. I thought we were just gonna be hitting some fire roads and like cruising, but we went like full three wheel motion. Like
really?
Yeah. Like back tire was like 5 feet up there. It was crazy. It's so fun. Yeah. These things can take some abuse.
Isn't there like a shelf inside this back door or something?
Yeah. The little. Toolbox holder,
I asked Rachel if that's where she changes diapers.
Probably. It might be able to hold a baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's sick that like it comes with like a toolkit. So like everything in here is like you take the hard top off fully, take the doors come off like two bolts.
Oh really?
And everything's included in here, so it's just like this really does everything. So
that's
yeah.
That's cool.
It's sweet. We took it to the beach, like me and my wife now.
Uh-huh.
Took it to the beach.
Wait, you're married now?
Yeah, I got married on Saturday.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Yeah, we took it to the beach and took the hard top off, took the doors off. Mm-hmm. Feel kind of lame, but like being in it with no doors and stuff is actually pretty rad.
Felt like old Jeep.
Yep.
Sick. So how's World Supercross prep coming?
It's been good. It's been really good. Team is like, you know, they stop at nothing to make sure the bike's ready to go, make sure I'm ready to go. We have to run the different fuel than what we're used to. So I started off on Pro 6 when we originally got on the 250 and had a lot of power. I was actually really surprised. I hadn't ridden the 250 in like 8 years. So
yeah,
had some good power, and then we had to switch to the ETS. So lost some of that, but the guy at XRP helped us out with some mapping, and I feel like we're right back to where we were, even with the slower fuel. Bike feels really good.
When you talk about this fuel, is it like worse than pump gas?
I don't think it's worse than pump gas. It's just like you get so much power out of the Pro 6.
Yeah.
Everybody knows that. So I'm sure they had to run it at Destinations this last weekend.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, congrats to the boys,
right?
Cooper, Sexton, and Eli. But yeah, we had to switch the fuel, and it's just something. I've ran on a 450 before, and with 450 you don't really notice it because it's, you know, it makes so much power. And even if you do notice, it's so much easier to get that power back. But with the 250, when you're trying to squeeze every little bit of power out of them, you notice it for sure, especially with Supercross.
Yeah.
So we got it. We got it all that like deficit that we had switching fuels. We made that up. So
I like the way the bike's like.
Yeah, it looks sick. Sam from SKDA. Like I've worked with him for a couple years now. So.
Morning, Tony.
Speaking of the devil.
Yeah. So that's how you say it? Yes, you say SKDA?
SKDA.
It's not Scuda?
It's Sam, I forget his last name.
Kinnison?
Kinnison, something like that.
Remember that?
Design of Australia, I believe.
Oh, there you go.
Oh, yeah. I wish it was a visor, huh?
I do.
I can't believe it.
It looks good. Do you think Vince looks good in that hat?
Got ourselves a new sponsor.
Yeah.
How is it?
Skidda.
Yeah, I still don't know what to say.
SKDA, according to...
It's not Skidda?
Skidda.
Jimbo Twisted always said
that's
that.
That's how you just say it all?
Okay. Did you pedal this weekend?
No. Oh. I don't want
to... Dude, do you hear that? He's scared to ride my bike. I told him I already crashed and fucked it up. Yeah. He could ride.
I put two dings in the rim needs a bigger already, hammer. And I'm like...
I told him just hammer the dent out. Yeah.
I got a pair of
pliers. I got mine for free, so I told him to take it for a rip, and he still...
Yeah. I got mine for free too. I was like, I even told him I already ate shit on fucked the frame all up.
Same.
You did screw the frame up pretty bad.
Yeah.
I showed Mitchell and he says, wow.
He broke the street. You had what? Like
it's a bike. You're supposed
straight?
To ride it, right?
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
What's that? He rode every day for what, 60, 90 yeah. days, something like that?
Something like that. And then I haven't ridden in almost a week.
He definitely logged the most miles.
Well, you've had my bike for 14 days and you only rode it twice?
14 days? I didn't even realize that. I've rode it three times.
Three times.
Yeah.
he's used to the Narco bike. He don't like the.
Yeah, he said mine don't have no power.
No, the Norco is way better.
He said my he didn't like my handlebar setup.
If he wouldn't unlock his bike, he wouldn't have this all this problem for something.
Yeah. Well, mine's unlocked. Mine's jailbroke.
No.
Yeah.
No, that thing is a turd.
It's meant to be a turd.
It's still locked up though.
But it'll go faster than 20.
It will.
Hmm. Because there's a jump out. There's a jump out hole that you have to go 26 for.
Wow. I guess I really didn't unlock it myself. Maybe it's on me. I did. I don't know. I just don't like the wheels. The wheels probably freak me out.
Yeah, aluminum wheels suck.
Well, they just not be on a.
You didn't like my tire setup. I don't have push cords.
It's soft. Like it feels like they roll. Like everything.
Well, he really got scared whenever you told him to get a bigger hammer.
Yeah, I said just hammer the dent out of my rim. It's no big deal.
I laughed so hard. He said, "Fuck, I'm gonna get a hammer." I'm like,
"Yeah, a hammer."
Oh, then Mitchell put a big flat spot in his, so I was like, "Oh, maybe I'll just hammer
that one too."
Hammer those ones.
I forgot my gear.
You definitely
just got my number on it.
Yep. I just moved it today, so I had all my helmets on
the
wall, and I took them down.
Golly,
these things are heavy.
Oh, Club 48.
Club 48. Yep. Yeah. It sucks, dude. I got 49 for here.
What off, huh?
Me
what
and
off?
I could do tied on points.
What's up?
Oh, what's up,
How
dude?
Are you?
I'm good.
You look good on this skate team.
Thank you. It's been a blast, so looking forward to it.
So, are you still on the other team for the U.S.?
Yeah. Playing as Bar X for West Coast Supercross.
Okay, so that's kind of crazy, huh? The team will let you go race for another team in a different series. And...
Yeah, I pulled a couple favors for sure.
Yeah.
But I'm pumped and it'll be good.
Yeah, that's good. You know the best thing about the canvas gear?
What?
You can't catch your wiener in the zipper.
No, dude, no zipper. Simple design, holds up. I'm pumped with it.
Dude, it's comfortable.
Yeah. Probably tying it up a little bit.
Yeah.
We're doing it. We've been doing a series of flashback pinups. You know, we did old intern Gino a while ago, and you know,
I mean,
you have your spot in history. You know,
you're doing my kids' bikes.
Huh? Yeah. Too many bikes, right?
If my kids are gonna have posters with girls on it, it's got to be me.
Yeah, that's gotta be mom.
You hear that, babe? I'm gonna do a pinup. Poster with Wyatt's bike.
Are you really?
With the minis.
I don't know if they've done those. Have you done one of those yet?
Mom and son.
We had this. We actually.
I want to be a bad thing. Get the moms to do a little pinup.
Let me go work out for them.
JG.
Yep.
So we're not getting ready for Day in the Dirt. We're getting ready for something serious.
No, we're getting ready for Day in the Dirt still, too.
Also.
Yeah.
But you'll be ready for Day in the Dirt after World Supercross.
Yeah. I'm going to have to take, like, that whole 2 weeks off to, like, recover even to hang for the party at Day in the Dirt.
How's things going?
It's good.
Yeah?
Having fun. It's been off and on the last couple of weeks, so just riding and having a good time.
So the attention has turned from the two kids to dad, right?
Yeah.
Or are you doing your motos in the day and working on mini bikes in the evening?
I still am doing that. Yeah, ooh. I was actually just at Paul all day yesterday, trying to get my kid to jump all the jumps.
Oh. So Wyatt and Easton, which one is the more naturally aggressive? Is it Easton, the younger one?
It's kind of a toss-up. Wyatt really wants to do it, really, like, a lot. Where Easton's, like, he's naturally talented and he's got the style, but he just is like, yeah, I don't care. Let's do it, whatever.
Dude, it's kind of always like that with two brothers, huh?
Yeah, but, and then Wyatt's just nonstop. Like, that's all he wants to do is ride his dirt bike.
No more baseball?
No, he doesn't want to play baseball right now. So our goal is to burn him out in some moto so he'll go back to the real stuff.
That's the goal?
Yeah, that's mom's goal at least, right?
Oh, man.
But, no, it's been good. Just trying to manage and balance all of it is difficult, but it's the only reason, like, one of the reasons by doing this, like, what made it so hard is because it's, like, it takes away from their time now.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I've had my time. I've done it 18 years, but we got an opportunity to go over there and obviously make a little dough and have some fun and race some dirt bikes. So it's, it's cool, but it's difficult.
So does the whole family get to go to Australia and England with you?
They're not going to England. We've talked about Australia, but in case we can't get the flights at a cheaper price, I don't know if they're going to go.
No, yeah, this is expensive. We're not going to Australia because Wyatt has informed me that is Cal Classic at Glen Helen.
No, Fall Classic.
Mom has to. Oh, it's Fall Classic. So yep. Mom has to take, and Grandpa will take Wyatt to race.
Racing. Yeah. The kid's got his priorities. He's a doer, not a viewer.
Yeah. He's like, nope, all right, you're leaving. I'm going to go race. He's like, I've done it with you before. When you got hurt at two-stroke national, you went to the hospital. I still raced without you. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, you're right. So go for it. But that's good.
Ty Katie, the red cowboy.
Chair boy.
Huh? Chair boy?
Chair boy.
That's your chair. Check out JG's helmet. Flat. So, Ty, are you still racing mountain bikes quite a bit?
Actually, just got back from Limestone last week, so that's that preserve across from over the hump. We got Victor's Filthy 50 coming in October and stuff like that. So yeah, I got some local stuff going on, and then Josh just called me up, and we've worked together for a few years, and said, hey, I got about 8 weeks to try to get fit. I'm like, oh, all right, well, let's see what we can do. So yeah, just put a little program for him together and see what we can get out of him before he heads off to England.
Okay, so when you were a professional racer on dirt bikes, I don't recall you being a, like, perfect physical specimen
at
fitness.
All. No, it's right? Horrible. Yeah, it was horrible.
So how did you develop
the knowledge?
The knowledge. You can gain the knowledge through experience, right? But what's the word I'm looking for? Just the discipline to just be gnarly.
For me, coming out of motocross, I knew I was pretty, I guess, disappointed. I kind of always wanted more, but I was a first-generation racer. So, and you know, the 90s, we didn't have all those technology, access to supercross tracks, heart rate monitors. And so it just really piqued my interest when I got into cycling and I saw how dedicated those guys were. And then I started working with some top athletes when I ran the specialized show air team. And so that really, like, piqued my interest to start, like, looking into it. Like, man, how do these guys, like, get so fit and so gnarly? And so I've always kind of had the discipline. I just never had the direction. Mm-hmm. So I was always just grasping at things and not really knowing which direction I was going in. And that just leads you spinning in circles. And so for me, mountain biking really taught me, like, just how to be more focused. And then I started going back to school and getting some education on it and getting basic physiology and stuff like that and getting some more knowledge and then how to apply that. So. Mm-hmm. It's for me, it was just a motivating factor since, I had about 20 minutes in me and then I was tired.
So did you become did all the training life come after your second, racing enthusiasm as a mountain biker?
Yeah, I definitely got way more dedicated because it's not a sport, in my opinion, that's purely like talent-based. I mean, when you look at someone like Josh coming basically off the couch, I mean, he gets sharp pretty quick. Like, he can ride better than a lot of people will ever be able to dirt bike, and I think it's that technical ability where a bicycle is just pure fitness. I mean, there's, especially in mountain biking, you have a little bit of skills and stuff, and so that really, really showed me how that I wasn't that fit. I mean, it took me years to just develop and work on that and work on those zones and stuff, and so, yeah, no, it's really, once mountain biking and then running into Johnny O and hanging him for quite a few years, just kind of seeing how it was done and then being able to apply it was really the thing that kind of took me to that next level.
So as a mountain bike racer, I know you've got all kinds of wins and everything. What are the accolades? What's the Ty Cady race resume?
Oh, man, don't do this to me. Quite a few. Well, I've got 8 national titles, but that's, you know, amateur master. So I think I'm pretty proud of that because I've won almost every discipline from cross country to short track to the 50-mile marathons. And I even won a Super D before it went to Enduro. You know, 10 Sea Otters and then a bunch of local races and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, fairly successful, I guess, at the master level.
Yeah. Do you look back at your motocross career and go, God damn it, if I had trained, what could have been?
A little bit, yeah, for sure. I mean, but again, I don't know that I had the technique, like just the raw talent some of these guys, and then equipment's such a big a big thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And this era is a little different. I mean,
it's funny because you can buy a 450 off the shelf.
Pretty damn
good. And it's competitive.
Right.
Back in our era with the two-strokes.
Remember those things? And then I'd be training at Star West.
Yeah.
That was Supercross. And then you show up to Anaheim and you're like, holy shit.
Yeah.
So like you just have to get through 3 or 4 rounds to figure it out without killing yourself. And then I'd kind of start finding my own rhythm where, yeah, between the bikes, they've got coaches and they've got these private tracks. I mean, that's why that level has just gone through the roof. So
in the 90s, all we had was Randy Danilo and his radios.
Yeah, that's right. We had Danilo and his trailer and the stripper pole and the
hot tub at Paris.
Yeah, hot summer nights for sure. So
okay,
yeah.
So as a trainer now, like obviously JG reached out to you. Are you working with any other motocross guys?
No, I kind of, once JG and some other guys kind of retired, I haven't got into motocross. I'm working with a couple guys at Estes and Yamaha, so JD Beach and Dallas Daniels, so flat track guys. And then a lot of the Nika kids, because that Nika series is blown up, so it's gotten back into cycling pretty heavily.
Nice.
So this is just kind of, I'm kind of moonlighting until he's done.
Yeah. Are you still on Baghouse?
Still on Baghouse.
Baghouse.
I'm even helping manage that a little bit, try to bring some organization for Chad there. So yeah, no, man, wearing it all. Jack of all trades, I guess.
Nice. Good seeing you.
Yeah, good seeing you, Donnie.
Cole says he's doing the scrub daddy.
Are you sponsored by Bogle?
Yeah, Bogle, you know, lent me a couple dollars. You kind of put him on the shoulder.
Okay, so we're in Orange County. Chase and I are being errand boys for the king. I guess it's like being man friends, huh? Are we being
Scott Bell's
man friends? Good. Tyler's Harley at Enzo. What's it, is that his turn signal?
Those are his turn signals, yeah. 6-speed.
There's no scrapes.
I think this is a gen before mine, so this is a 96.
I don't see any scrapes back here, so.
No.
He's not doing wheelies yet.
He hasn't busted the taillight yet. See, I always come through the back.
Rossi. We have fork and chalk from the king, Jeremy McGrath. You know that
that's a Honda, isn't it?
No, it's a aluminum frame KX250F chassis with a KX250 two-stroke engine in it.
It's for straight rhythm?
No, it's for world vets.
It's gonna ride a two-stroke?
That's what he says.
A lot of people are here.
I feel like we're in Nordstrom's or something. Changing rooms? He's clapped out on it. 97, one try of national champ. Dude, one 900 pro race. That was like a phone sex line, but with race reports.
What? Really?
1-900-PRO-RACE. You called, enter your credit card number, and it would tell you results and like some other stuff. Could you imagine if Anton ran it? You wouldn't call till like Thursday. Hey, nothing moves. Try to pull a lever.
Oh, you
broke it. I think I just broke it.
Well, what are your childhood memories of this bike? Were you even, were you like diapers though, huh?
Yeah, I didn't watch this live.
Yeah.
Obviously, I know the story though.
Jumped into the bay?
It's like, yeah, it's like the first iconic moment of Travis Pastrana, I feel like.
Yeah.
What year was it?
1999.
Yeah, so what, he's like 15?
Yeah, he wasn't
even racing. He was 15, right? Because he won an outdoor title at 16 in 2000. Mm-hmm. What a legend. Do you see his videos of him like doing his rally car thing still?
Dude, ridiculous.
Slow down, TP.
Yeah.
Slow down.
How weird is this to see? Like, that was when No Fear was just t-shirts. But he wore Fox because No Fear. Do you remember No Fear t-shirts?
Oh yeah.
Yeah?
Of course.
They got kind of ridiculous when it was like a picture of a putting green and it's like on and two, 5 foot putt, No Fear.
No. Really?
There were some lame ones.
So, no,
locked up.
Salt water.
No flip levers on this thing.
Feel that chain, RL. Here at the Wednesday Rob Healy GoFundMe ride day. LA County. Hopefully I jumped that stupid jump today. I've done it 100 times. I don't know why I didn't do it on Saturday. Comes, oh, that's not scrubby. I never understand why this is the place where Scrub Daddy goes the best. He's so fast here. I think because there's no bumps. I don't know. Hopefully, last weekend I passed him, even though I wasn't doing the big jump, but gotta do the jump today. The usual cast of characters. These are all the normal guys. These are the normal guys that support the Rob Healy GoFundMe.
That's it.
Huh? Oh, the shame. Well,
speaking of which, I have to make my contribution. So yeah, a normal ride day here at LA County is $40. Well worth the price of admission. Rob Healy GoFundMe day is $60. Here's my 60 big ones.
Oh yeah, the GoFundMe Healy, thank you very much.
Good luck
much.
With everything, I hope
thank
it turns
you,
out okay.
Thank you, using AT&T.
Now, $50 says when I walk up, Papa will say, 9 o'clock, bro. Because I was a little bit late today. But he's the king of being late. Hawaiian. See, I told you.
He's late again, everybody.
Hey, wait, I see you've really been wearing this gear I got you.
I have.
Well, because there's still a fucking tag thing on the back. So that means you wore it today for the first time. Jeez, well, do you think you could get a new helmet? This thing is yellow. Bob Weber.
You know why?
Let's get
hard
it
hopping enduro, bro.
Hard enduro? No, it's like you leave it in the backyard in the sun.
Hey.
Look at that one! That one's supposed to be fluorescent yellow!
I know. That one's
dude,
a year older.
We need to call Bob Weber.
I was just gonna walk over there and sit down.
Okay. Okay, how's our FC450? That's a nice stand. Did you forget your stand again? Oh, Jesus. Did you do the uphill triple yet?
I did.
Did you?
Finally.
Is it fourth or third? It's third. Isn't it? Yeah. Healy stand fourth.
Honestly, the hardest part is getting over that.
Before. So I came Saturday and I didn't do it all day.
Dude.
But then I went to Elsinore the next day and did all fucking ginormous shit.
Have you been out yet?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rob Healy, the leaseholder today, okay. He couldn't do the jump. So he complained and they're fixing the jump.
That's called GoFundMe service.
I'm pumping, jumping, scrubbing, you'll get a picture.
But when I do it, you're gonna do it next, right?
No, I'm not ready.
Jack.
Today's an off day too.
Jack, that's the same as doing Tombstone.
I know. Well, I don't know, but I got an idea. I'm not ready right now, Don. I need a couple more months. My back, I'm pulling the back card because if I fucking case it or go overshoot, I'm gonna be out.
You're done, huh?
It's always.
Hey, there's only 2 weekends left in Summit.
I know.
Are you coming this Friday?
No.
You're gonna miss the rest of the season. Jack.
I only did 2. I'm intimidated, dude. I wanna get fucked up. Especially if I go with you, dude. I'm gonna be chasing you.
Dude, you're the one that smokes me at Summit.
No, I'm gonna be chasing you and. I'm just not there. You're fucking comfortable on the bike right now. You're where I was.
The first year I saw you.
When I was, and that was how many years ago? Because a couple years after that is where I was really comfortable.
Yeah.
But, I was riding a lot, you know, and like where you're on, I can tell you're fucking in tune with it. You're fucking good,
dude. I'm going to look at this too. I don't know, I've done it 100 times, but I'm scared of it every week.
That's I haven't ridden since March, and I got here, and we used to jump it all the time, and I'm like, God, why is it in my head?
Right?
I just don't want to get hurt anymore.
I know. Actually, I was in fourth though, dude. Third's too revved out.
Oh, not for me, but you're scared because you can't see.
Alright, let's do the top one now.
Huh?
Let's do this one that you're on though.
Mm-hmm. I did a brake check and then put a clutch.
What?
Cock cock. I mean,
it where'd was you so do close. It? Where'd you do it?
I did a.
No, where?
On the table.
So you styled it almost caught killed yourself?
And it died like in mid-air, like halfway, and I was just like, if I'd have popped the clutch, I would have went over. So I just held the clutch in and coast off, and I was like, that's it. That was the biggest brain fart of my life.
Man.
I'm still thanking the Lord.
I would have had to take you home again, huh?
Amen. See, that's what I'm talking about.
So
that's all I was saying.
Oh, wait, that's why you're done? Because you scared yourself?
Yeah, that one got me.
I know why you're done.
That's all I did.
What? You wasn't coming?
You saw me.
Never.
He saw me.
He saw me out to guess what he did. He watched on the side, see me hit the jumps.
You know what I told him? What I'm going to bring
you. You should write fairy tale books, dude. You're full of like.
I saw you at Happa.
Fantasy.
What was y'all doing sitting there? What, instead of coming?
Oh, when you took back. Because we just did like 8 laps.
Hey, Scrubby, I told Donna I'm going to bring you a big pink boa.
He thinks you're gay.
You're so flamboyant out there that whipping and scrubbing everything.
Hey, this is the first.
Is good?
This is the first time I've looked up to you.
Okay, he's going to get it. He's like, nope. And then the whole time you greased it, and then you went back and still
forgot. I know. I have to grease the bottle.
Gotta get the dig in. What is that? 350 or
4? Yeah, 350.
It sounds brand new.
Hey,
yeah, it is.
Hey, that's the guy that was casing it.
11 hours.
King case.
I'm learning. This is only like the 9th time I've ever even hit it. So I tried it.
Oh damn!
So, yeah.
Alive. Hey, he bought a 350 because of us.
Yes. Oh yeah,
that's right.
He looked good on it.
Yeah, he does.
You know what's funny is I swear I thought you was like a young kid.
I feel like it.
Cause he's all little, huh?
Even, yeah,
he don't have the big man stomach like you.
You see the way he's chased that jump. Huh? Oh, look at that! Shady came back again.
Very fortunate.
It's that back shock just sucks it up. Doesn't look so good.
And then you came and did it like,
yeah.
And then he came back and showed it
really different.
Yeah, that's
hey, seriously, put your gear back on. We didn't get to race.
Yeah, it just came out of the package.
The Lord just saved me. Yeah. See, what the devil meant for harm, God meant it for good. See, the Lord was like, hold on. Put his hand right there, guide me on in.
I like her.
There's no way I should have saved that. I'm telling you. I had too many crashes like that.
Who's got a Sharpie?
So you got to quit doing your brake taps.
Well, I was tired. And I was like, okay, this is going to be my last lap.
You never say last lap either.
See, I ain't got all the energy like you got. He rides bikes. I mean, he rides 8 times a week.
No, you guys are amazing.
I do not ride as much as you.
Triathlete.
Uh-huh. Since all the tracks closed.
No, I ride that thing.
I know you're in love with that thing. I see how much you be bragging on it.
Bragging?
Jack, let me see what you got. Can you come down that hill?
Yeah, Finn could do it. Finn's a monster.
He said, you good.
He's a monster on mountain bikes.
Slippery. So you hit the right at the bottom.
I come down that hill, Jack. Halfway.
Now I'm going home by way of Valencia, the front side. Going to stop in and see my buddy Jeff Patterson, who coincidentally was partners with my buddy Hoppe when they started Liep Race USA. Whew. Well over 10 years ago, 15 maybe, 20, I don't know. It's been a long time. But we're in Valencia. I actually used to live in Valencia, or technically I think my zip code was Canyon Country, maybe 20 years ago, 25 years ago. And Hoppe likes to call it Awesome Town. I don't know about that, but it's certainly changed a lot since I lived up here. Actually, the last time I was in this area was in early 2019 after Trans World Motocross was folded, and I actually came up here to have a meeting with the High Torque guys about motocross action. Jeff Patterson.
Yeah.
How are you, buddy?
Tired, man.
Back from another country?
New Zealand, yeah.
New Zealand. Were you showing the Hitch Hotel?
Yeah, we got two of them down there right now. We have a distribution all set up, and it looks like we're going to Australia as well. And we met up with the CEO of all of New Zealand for Hyundai, and they're like,
oh, wow.
Yeah, we might want to do something with you guys. So,
dude, like an official import.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sick.
Yeah, they have 30 dealerships down there. So it was a good deal. But I got back at 3 and I'm exhausted.
Oh,
so,
I bet.
But it was all good.
Okay, so So Jeff here, how many years ago was that you shoved the Liat brace around my neck with Hoppe?
It was in 2006, and when we got there, Jason said, I'm too afraid to go talk to him. I said, well...
he's still too afraid.
No, he's a ding-dong. Yeah, I said, dude, we got to do it. It was almost raining. It was scary cold. So we get there, and I walk up. You're standing around. All your people are all standing around you, and I walk up, slapping around your neck. You're like, who is this joker?
I thought you were putting a bondage thing
on
my neck.
I know. 2 weeks later, I get a call, and he says, I'll never ride without it. So,
yeah,
and we've been buddies ever since. So.
Okay, so Liat brace... you made Liat brace what it was in the United States in its heyday.
Yeah.
It's kind of taken a little bit of a fall off here and there. You've since gone on to pursue other things aside from your collision center.
Yeah, my brother runs that. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, I don't run it anymore.
It's not you anymore.
No, I'm off doing
this. You're pursuing your passions.
Well, I don't know if trailers are my passions, but I think it's a worldwide product, so.
Yeah. So you've been talking about this thing forever. I saw the first version was actually on a hitch only.
Mm-hmm.
It's since evolved into wheels.
Yeah.
I had it in my vlog at one of the Supercrosses. San Diego?
Anaheim. We were at Anaheim.
Okay.
It had wheels on it there.
Okay.
The reason we put wheels on it is because no country other than the United States can support it. The weight, a big vehicle like this can support it, but the rest of the world has small vehicles. And
the little weenie-ass cars in Europe.
So I've traveled all over the world, both for Liat and for Hitchhotel, and everything is small.
Yeah.
So I said, well, and actually one of my good friends, who was someone that I've loved forever, she said, she kept telling me, put a wheel on it, put a wheel on it. And finally we did, and here we are.
Do you have some here?
I have one sitting over in the corner. It's all blocked away, but yeah, it's
out.
A prototype.
I want to see it.
Check it out. And I got my
Dan the Dirt shirt.
So it's all
good. That one looks like from like Dan the Dirt 4 or something.
Well, I took all my clothes down to New Zealand.
Yeah.
And they're all scattered out, and I got home at 3 in the morning.
Yeah. So. All right.
It's probably pretty noisy in here. Don't mind the chaos. It's
You know, I grew up in this chaos.
In the auto body world?
Yeah, you knew my dad owned Mike's Body and Fender Shop.
There you go.
Yeah.
That's right.
I learned how to Bondo before I knew how to do paper airplanes.
Well, I've been doing it for quite a while, but so this is our first real unit we've used in the US. It's more of a prototype than anything else, but
wow.
I got it stuffed in the corner because we were kind of look up inside there. There's the floor.
Yeah, well, we saw it in
We
saw it at Supercross, but it expands.
There's a full-blown battery AC and heater unit that sits in here. There's a window on the other side. It's all vented through here. You can put a motorcycle on the front.
No way. Can you really?
Yeah. So I don't have the rack here.
So you'll have one of those a ramp thing or
the... So it'll be a ramp. I've already done it. There's a picture on Instagram somewhere with my bike on it.
Mm-hmm.
But for the guy that drives a little car that wants to go racing and wants to spend the night at the track,
that's perfect.
You got this deal. So it weighs 950 pounds.
That's nothing.
Yeah, it weighs nothing. So the smallest car.
That's less than the jet ski I rode last week.
Yeah,
I think.
Most likely.
Or feels like.
Like the big ones. So yeah, man, this is kind of clapped out right now.
Ah, it looks nice inside though.
But it's, it's got vented windows. They're dual pane, they're screened and blinded.
Mm-hmm.
So it's been an 8-year run though, man.
So you have heating and air in this thing now.
Heating and air.
Wow.
The AC runs up through here, heating runs up through here, and the power runs up through there.
I feel like the first ones you showed me like years and years ago were just a box.
It was a box, yeah. Had no front window.
Yeah.
I said, I'll have it ready in a week.
Yeah, I remember that.
8.5 years later, buddy.
Yeah.
It's been a grind, but this New Zealand trip was awesome. I'm actually heading over to the World Supercross next Wednesday.
Oh, okay, Cardiff.
To meet with Mike Genova.
Uh-huh.
The possibility of him setting me up with distribution over there.
Okay.
So I'm going to meet with my daughter for a few days, and we're all going to go up to Wales, and we're going to hang out with him. I can't wait to see that program.
Yeah.
That's the first of its
kind.
Nice. So
yeah, it's going
to
be cool.
To it for sure. You're not going, are you?
No, Anton's going.
Yeah.
He's an international traveler. You know, here he has a scarf pack.
And traveling, it's getting
traveling
old,
sucks.
Isn't it?
Oh. Sucks, dude. I've been doing it for 35 years. I don't even like being up here in Valencia. I'd rather be home in Corona.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, stop two on the tour of Valencia is to see my pal Scott Gilley at Factory FX. I walked right in, and there's the king. So what, you turned 60?
I'm 60 years old.
And you're still surfing and mountain biking and
yeah, probably doing motoring. More now than I ever have.
What's up, buddy? How are you?
You all right?
I'm good. So?
Welcome to the abode.
Where's Cobra?
There's Chuckles right there.
There's Chuck. Oh, wow. There's Chuck Cobra. Yeah, I know, dude. I'm up in the enemy territory.
Santa Clarita.
Huh? How are you?
Long time stomping grounds.
How are you? You know the last time I was in Valencia?
When you lived here?
No.
Dahmer and you came out when you first started Swapmoto.
Oh, yeah, and you told us we'd never
actually,
make it.
You didn't start it yet. You talked about starting it.
Yeah, Gilly told me it was a failing business plan and we never cut it.
Yeah.
But no,
I don't listen to Gilly either.
I was thinking the last time before that, though, I had a little meeting at this really old, looked like a Brady Bunch decoration office up the street, shag carpet. Everyone in there was depressed.
Where's, that's not us.
And they made like, it smelled like magazines in there.
Oh, it's still there.
Yeah, I know.
And we won't name names because I love those guys. Yeah. But you go down the building to that building now, which is same street, half a mile down.
Oh.
One person in that entire building actually physically goes into that building and works.
Oh, really?
If it was depressing back when you were the last there.
It was.
Oh, man.
Really depressing now?
Really? It's, yeah. Yeah. But you know what? We're still partners of those guys and we work with them and do some good stuff. Right.
Is this you?
Yeah, the Gilley.
So I think this is a different building than I was last at.
Yeah, come over here and I'll show you the old building real quick.
Look at that. Gilley helmet. What is this thing?
That was, there's a real interesting story.
Is that an AGV?
So I had a customer of mine from Chile.
Uh-huh.
Back when I was the sales manager for Answer Products. This is like 900 years ago. And his name was Fabio. He'd come out once a year and hang out with me.
Mm-hmm.
I'd take him riding. He'd go to Supercross and do some business. Good guy. Bought a lot of stuff from us. So he walks in the office one day and he has this helmet bag and he opens up this helmet bag and out comes this helmet. And, you know, this realistically 30 years ago, right?
Yeah.
He goes, I just got back from Troy Lee. He painted this bitchin' helmet for me.
Uh-huh.
I go, wow, what a great helmet. He goes, do you like it? And I go, yeah, I really like it. He goes, do you want it? I go, yeah. He goes, give me 5% off my next order. And I'll give you the helmet.
So he did it.
So
what
I did
is it. M-H-O?
No. It was, what was the name of the company?
What?
Guy from Australia. We all knew him. You knew him, too. What was that?
M2R?
M2R helmet, yeah.
That's M2R?
Yeah.
Ooh, it looks like you rode in it and fell in it a couple times.
Oh, man. I freaking raced with this helmet for a lot of years. I think I was riding big blocks back then, so I was on the dirt a lot.
Oh.
KX500.
Oh, look at this. I've got one of these.
Stewball. So the story behind this helmet that James signed, this is when he won his first 125 championship.
Uh-huh.
And for a celebration, Kawasaki and James put together a go-kart thing when Ken Fott first opened.
P2R, yeah.
P2R. Did you go to that? You were probably there.
Maybe, I don't know.
It was the weekend of the college football championship.
Okay.
James really into football, college football. So anyhow, yeah, we all drove out there, Breyer, myself, you know, we had a couple of employees across the street. We all went, raced go-karts with James and drank some beers and hung out and watched football. But you know where that's at. That's like on the other side of the state of California. I don't think we got home to like 1:30 in the morning.
Well, it was brutal. That's where I live.
Huh?
I live close to P2R.
Yeah, there you go. So, right?
See, I'm far away here.
Yeah, you are far away. Here, show you the other building. See, if you can see across the street through those trees. Right over there.
Yeah. That's a building I remember. Yeah. I remember that. Okay, what is this? This is a fake showy.
That's a fake showy. I want to say this is an Answer helmet.
Yeah.
Another Troy Lee.
Oh, you busted the shit out of that.
Yeah, two or three times.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is what happens when you take a helmet that used to have the shark fins on it, trail riding.
Oh, I hit a tree.
Every time I went trail riding, I'd hit a tree and bust this thing. So I actually learned how to paint it.
Because you kept repainting it?
Well, yeah, because I'd call up Troy. I go, hey, Troy, so I busted up another shark fin. Yeah, and he goes, cool.
Yeah. See, I see this version.
When can you have it done? There you go. Yeah. I go, when can you have it done? He goes, oh, you know, I'll bust it out in a month and a half, you know, which really meant 3 months.
Yeah.
I'm like, I can't. My bike won't start if I don't look cool with my helmet. So yeah. I figured out how to paint it myself. As you can see, the color match wasn't.
Yeah. Well, what is this, Gilly?
Factor Effects thought at one point it should get into the wheel business.
Oh.
And this was about,
I think you were telling me about that.
A decade ago. We actually built a wheel that offered some improvement and benefit. Mm-hmm. It was lighter. It had special bearings in it. You know, Star Racing Yamaha, which, you know, we birthed that team, developed the Star Racing logo. Mm-hmm. You know, eons ago with Bobby, we were his first partner, really, to sponsor the team when they were racing out of a Class C motorhome.
Yeah.
So we decided we were going to be a wheel guy. We thought there was an opportunity to be a wheel guy. So we designed and made wheels. We created our own rims. And the project was good. We had great success selling wheels all over the world. Star Racing, Max Dancy won his first Supercross at Anaheim in the mud with our wheels. Mm. So that was for us, it was a big deal. But the wheel market, you know, finding reliable vendors to make product that you can trust and believe in became a little bit more challenging, and wheels carry a lot of liability. Something
goes
wrong.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. Yeah.
Guys wind up going over the bars, and, you know, when you get those phone calls from people, you kind of, it bums you out.
Yeah.
So really what drove us is we had a couple of wheels fail, which was, for me, after selling a couple of thousand sets of wheels, a couple of wheels was enough. And I'll never forget this dude. We were in the building across the street, comes in one day and goes, hey, you know, my name's Steve, and what, I can't remember the guy's name. Just, you know, I was riding my brand new CRF 450, and my hub, rear hub sprocket side broke, and my chain wrapped around and slapped my engine case and blew a hole in my engine case. And I'm looking at this dude going, I don't ever want to have this conversation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that was it.
That's a better conversation than... It locked up and I went over the bars.
Yeah,
and
my jaw's wired shut, or whatever the case may be. So yeah, we decided to
stick to safe things.
Yeah,
like,
you know, stay in our wheelhouse. And at that like time, you know, as
graphics,
it is right now, is graphics.
Officially,
you know,
licensed products.
Yeah, we do a lot of apparel now. Probably half of our business now is apparel.
Really?
We still think we're the number one graphic company in
the
world.
Dude, I think the stands you make are the shit.
Yeah, you know, we sell, you know, during COVID, everyone knows COVID blew up and sales were great. That's when we first introduced the stands, kind of at the beginning of COVID, and you know, I guess I'm not giving away any secrets. We were importing 5 and 6 40-foot containers at a time of stands, you know, and as fast as we offloaded the containers in the back,
and shipping them out,
we didn't even put them away in the inventory. They were all sold.
You know what? You know what's so good about them? They're smaller. They're more compact, so they take up less room in your van.
Yeah, only you would notice something like
and
that.
And they're taller.
Yeah.
They're taller, so they get both wheels off the ground. Like when you have a Honda or a KTM, one wheel's always on the ground.
Yeah.
On your stand, they're both off.
Yeah, and we saw that little wedge.
Yeah, you have the wedge, and that's good, but if you position the bike right, you don't need it.
Yeah, yeah. I was never stoked on, I think Honda's probably more susceptible than anything. You put the bike on the stand and it does, you know, it's doing a wheelie.
Yeah, yeah.
It just doesn't look cool.
Yeah, and the KTM does endo.
Yeah, it does endo. Come on, I'll show you around a little bit more.
How's it going?
Not too bad, yourself?
Oh, feel out of sorts up here in the 661.
Breyer's office.
Oh, Brian, are there any quick straps here?
Yeah, probably some around here somewhere. Art department, everyone's out for lunch. You know, Craig, our art director.
Everyone's directed, art is done.
Yeah, it's gone.
Hey, hey.
Guess who I found?
We're taking a tour.
Taking a tour,
how's it going, Don?
Pretty good.
So.
All good?
Yeah.
So is he the one that?
No.
He's the one that's going to clean up my design when I make it on the computer?
Yeah.
Me.
Anything actually send us, he cleans up before you post it.
Fix all my stuff.
I fix everything.
He's a fixer.
I'm
a fixer.
Cleaner.
Yeah, we just got done doing fall ads. Fall ads are done now.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be coming out pretty soon with the buddies down the street and the boys in Virginia. Their fall ads. We just redesigned our camping chairs too.
Oh yeah?
We did decided to do. That's a good business for us. So we're...
Yeah, you're all sold out right now.
Yeah.
All right, Gilly, good seeing you, buddy.
Thanks for stopping by, player.
Thanks for deciding to support us after telling me we would fail.
Yeah. You guys kill it. I got an ante.
You gonna come ride mountain bikes with me soon?
Yeah, I'd like to.
Yeah, let's go.
I gotta somehow pull about 10 years of my life back, and then I can keep up with it.
Oh, no. Don't you want...
We could helicopter in and drop us both up on top of a mountain, and there's ride-arounds and all these step-downs you're doing.
Hey, Snow Summit's open for two more weeks.
I know, let's go.
Sorry. It's fucked. I know. I get pissed. It's crazy too, because it's sun is bad.
Yeah.
But also the air is so dry, man. It's drying on my eyeballs. Trump wall.
They made it nice. The landing is like packed, almost packed
asphalt. Isn't there like a step down on the left?
Yes.
And then there's a step up, right?
Right away.
Okay.
All right, ready?
Yeah.
Something broke.
Huh?
Like clack.
Oh, it was my helmet.
Holy shit. Did you see it?
No, I was riding on the fire road. I heard it. I was like, oh shit.
No, so you said land front wheel first.
Yeah.
So I landed really front wheel first and fucking just yarded.
You made it all the way to here?
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks. This one caught you last time too.
Not as bad as this one did. This was fucking.
How'd you get all the way to here?
Slid.
Holy shit. Are you bleeding?
Oh, yeah. Nothing. I don't know. I feel like there was no lip before. This is a lip.
A little bit. I'm gonna go as fast as I can go.
Wait, what is this turn up now?
That's the
Wait, so that's an RM engine, chassis, RMX chassis.
RMS.
X. RMX. And what engine is it? WR200?
Yeah. I think it's a DRZ tank, right?
No, that's RMX tank.
Yeah, oh. Dude, that is awesome. That is pure commitment.
Yeah, it was definitely. But it is
a lot of work.
Paying off.
Heck yeah.
Yeah. It's a beater, but.
You're riding.
Yep.
That's all that matters.
Dude, that's a rear brake on the front.
This is the front brake.
I know, but that's a rear master cylinder. But you made it work.
Yeah, all my other ones went out because the little
plungers that don't say goodbye.
Dude.
Yeah, I know. It's hey. The back tire with a drum brake. It had a lot of things.
You're riding though.
Yeah, it's pretty reliable.
Life on two wheels.
That's pretty cool how you took that hill down there.
I almost crashed. The sun was in my face.
Today is not our usual setting. Today, my buddy Todd Shockwell and I are riding mountain bikes up in LA County. And on the way out, we run into our guy, Brian, here, who has this bike. I think you, built it yourself, right?
Correct, yes. Scratch everything, ground up, new engine, lots of welding.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
So this started out, I believe this is a RMX 250, right? A Suzuki, but you have a 94 and you have a Yamaha engine in it?
Yeah, 200, a WR200R, one of a kind.
Okay, so you have made things work on this motorcycle that just blow me away. We saw you on our way out of the trail, and Todd and I are riding down the street going, man, we're spoiled. You know, we ride these new bikes and everything, and this guy wants to ride so bad, he made anything happen. So what were some of the biggest challenges putting this thing together?
Every part of it.
Yeah?
Every part of it. No mounts matched. I had to make my own mounts. Every part of it was difficult, but it was worth it.
Okay. How hard was it to get the engine to fit in the chassis and for the chain to line up with the wheel?
Luckily, the back of it has the main ear of the back of the engine fits where the RM250 engine fits. So on the back it actually fit, but the front had to weld a bunch of mounts. But it worked out good. Exhaust, perfect.
You had to cut the exhaust a little, right?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Went right on.
Okay, and then this is a rear brake master cylinder you have working for the front brake.
Yeah, it's a foot pedal brake. Yeah. It is.
How does she run?
Good.
Yeah?
Very good. Very surprisingly good. I thought going to from a 250 would be slow, but no, it's faster.
She's a runner. Putting you on the spot, Ollie.
Here we go.
Ollie Stone. Man, new crew chief.
New crew chief, yep.
At Red Bull. Troy Lee Designs Gas.
Yes.
Is it still the fun team?
We try to have some fun. It's hard to say. It's more fun when you win, put it that way. So yeah. I want to win.
to have fun, but you got to have fun to win. So it's like catch 22. But we have some fun. We have a good group of guys, and the riders stand the same for next year. And we got JB who likes to have some fun. And
yeah. I think JB's vlog did wonders for his popularity,
because
people don't really realize how funny he is, you know.
I hate me for saying this, but sometimes he might act it up a little bit for the camera. But depends on what you get with JB. Depends how many espressos he's had in the morning before he gets on the track, because he can have a few.
Yeah.
Caffeine can hit him pretty hard, but he's quite tolerant to the caffeine. So the coffee in the morning, it can definitely send him buzzing.
Okay, so crew chief, you've been a mechanic for several riders through the years.
I have, yeah.
How will your day-to-day duties change there? I mean, you won't be responsible for just one guy's bike.
No, it'll be more input, more parts, more overseeing. I want to make sure my mechanics have what they need to do the job. Reports, speaking with Austria, speaking with Ian and Roger, running things by with WP. Just more of a overseeing kind of thing, but more of a, rather than just be focused on Justin's bike, it'll be more, I've got three bikes that I need to be in charge of and make sure they're good, or, I mean, not good, but just make sure that they have what they need and move forward like that.
Who's taking over as Justin's mechanic?
We've got Cody, came along from the team. He came from, he worked for Savage earlier in the year, so he came in halfway through the summer as like a shop guy. So to move him into the 450 program, he's got experience with that. So it's just a perfect fit, really, I think.
Okay, give me the rundown of riders you've wrenched for. And
in Europe and America, or just America?
Yeah, Europe and America. And give me a sentence about each guy.
Each guy. I worked for a few boys in America too, but obviously I started as a privateer team. In the end, I was at Jackie Mines KTM, so at the end it was Joel Rulance, who was a good rider over there in the MXGP days, and then Jake Nichols was my last guy there. But then when I came here, I went to Pro Circuit, and I was there until I moved to Gas last year. So first year at PC was Justin Hill. It was my rookie year, his rookie year, so that was like, we both had a lot to learn. But obviously Justin figured it out pretty quick, because he was a champ, Supercross champ by the end of it, so that was cool. And then I worked for Bowers, who is... No, I worked for Dino actually after Justin. All the years have just merged into one. So I worked for Dean. So I worked for Dean in 14, which was cool. Everyone knows Dean, and I got along good with Dean. So we're still really good friends to this day. So not really a sentence, but everyone knows Dean, like chief vlogger, like chip off the old block. You know, like the people's champ, pretty much. So we got Dino, and then I worked for Bowers for 2 years, I think. And that was like, he came from the arena cross days, and then he filled in at PC once when we won a race in Vegas, I think in 13. So he kind of, Mitch hired him. We did supercross. Well, he did supercross because he was hurt for motocross, or more of a supercross expert. So we did Barris, and that was funny stories. Like, it was, he's the bear, you know? So like, we had a lot of meetings that year with the AMA officials, like almost as many as being mechanic with Justin. But Barris wouldn't take no shit from anyone. So I remember him and Osborne, whatever, the few run-ins, but they were buddies too. So then after Bowers, it was Austin Faulkner. So that was when he came through the Team Green program, and then Bowers was hurt one summer, so I ended up going to the amateurs, like Loretta's and what's the other one, Minio's. I went to Minio's one year too, so I did that kind of thing. And then Mitch signed Austin, and I was Austin's guy until I left Pro Circuit last year, so it was 6 or 7 for Austin, so it was a long time.
And then Justin, obviously.
How
was it working with him?
I know you were pumped when you got to
have a red plate bike.
Oh yeah, red plate 450 class. Yeah, that was quite an achievement for my first year in the 450 program. But I was nervous to work with Justin, because you hear all these horror stories and stuff, but actually, we became pretty good friends, and I'm from England, and his wife's English, and I think he likes England just as much as he likes America. Maybe he drinks a cup of tea or something like that, but he was there. He likes to spend more time in England than he does back here, so we actually got on really good, and we clicked, and he's got some good English humor too. Like, I'm super sarcastic, as dry as they come, so he kind of gelled to that, so it was really good. And then for me to move up, I think he was disappointed to lose me as my mechanic, but happy that that I can be have a little more input into the, mm-hmm. the program for him, so he should benefit from this also. Yeah.
Have you guys started testing with the new bike yet?
What new bike?
Well, the bike that
Oh, the gas gas. The 2023 gas gas.
The
2023
gas gas. We're going to race the
2023. Factory edition. I don't know what he's talking about.
Okay. Okay, changing subjects.
Okay.
There's, so I went on, I went to Singapore.
Okay.
And the resort I was in had this breakfast buffet that had everything, right?
Okay.
And I gravitated towards the English breakfast.
Okay, but what was your okay? English breakfast?
Bangers and mash.
Oh, not for breakfast.
Dude.
Bangers and mash for breakfast?
Well, in beans.
Yeah, baked
but,
beans.
You know what they didn't have that I always, I don't, I've heard of it, I don't know what it is, but what is spotted dick?
Spotted dick. It's almost, spotted dick. That's more of a an evening lunch meal, not
but what
really
is
breakfast.
It?
I'm going to have to Google it. It's,
I don't you've never had spotted dick?
I don't
dick?
Think I really ate it as a kid growing up. We have but bangers and mash is more of a evening meal because it's
just
mashed potato. Really?
Yeah.
It's just mashed potato and sausages.
Yeah.
So we call our sausages bangers. But like an English breakfast for me is like the baked beans, bangers.
Mm-hmm.
They do like a fried potato, not fried
yeah.
potato, or like yeah, or fried bread. It was mm-hmm. fried bread, fry our tomatoes. I said baked beans, bacon, but soft bacon.
Soft,
American,
yeah.
you kind of like cook it a little
overcooked.
Much.
No,
like,
soft bacon is good.
No one likes crispy bacon, where I come
yeah.
from.
Yeah. So the one thing I really like from my, I went to Destinations.
This past weekend.
No, okay. years and years ago.
Yeah.
And. James and I went and got fish and chips, and I got mushy peas.
Yes, mushy peas.
Amazing.
Yes, yes.
Love
I don't
it.
See that over here either.
I can't eat peas when
but
they're in
they're
their round
like
state.
They're just like all smashed up.
Yeah.
They're like overcooked, but then they're like puree almost.
Yeah.
It might look like guacamole, but it doesn't taste like
it's
guacamole.
It's amazing.
But
it,
but I would always like, so like you get your fish and chips, and it was it wrapped in newspaper?
Yeah.
Like authentic.
Yeah.
But I always used to like curry sauce in mine. Some of the boys back home might relate, but like fish, chips, and curry sauce, and then you just dip your chips in your curry sauce. That was my go-to. Not really mushy peas, but the curry
sauce. Yeah, UK's where I had my first taste of Indian food as well.
Oh,
so
really?
Said,
yeah, the Indian food over there is legit too.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah.
But mushy peas. Mushy peas yield some championship caliber farts.
Really?
Too.
Okay. Yeah. So, but then next time you go back, you need the curry sauce also.
Curry
fish
sauce.
Chips, mushy peas, and curry sauce. That's like
okay.
the.
And I still got to figure out what spotted dick is.
Yeah, we'll
I think A-Ray's probably suffered it, but.
Maybe
I don't know
can
he's
you
eating
take
it.
A shot of penicillin to get rid of it, maybe?
Okay, Fridays, I'm usually at Snow Summit. But all my friends are hurt. Or soft, or have to work. What are these things called jobs, man? Work at night like I do. Anyway, here at Marshall Canyon Trail, temperatures cooled off a little bit, so brought the pooch. She's on a leash right now. Got her on a leash right now. Connected to my waist, but that's mostly because we ride through the neighborhood to get here. I think I could let her off now. You ready to be free? Huh? Don't be an idiot. So for the most part, doggy has, come on me, to the right, come on, sorry. Sick music, dick face. Anyway, for the most part, dude, she's like a dream come true for me. Huskies do not do well off leash. Yuki would pin it and ditch me. But my buddy Al trained her well when she was young. Tired? Your cousins pull sleds 80 miles a day in Alaska. It's not that hot here. Okay, it's Saturday morning, and I had to open up a new bell helmet because I wadded one earlier in the week. So, thanks to Benny. Speaking of Benny, removing Benny from the vlog today after this ride. He's moving in with his sauce. World Series of Love status. So, Boyd and I are here with low morals on our pedal assist bikes today. Low morals equals more laps. Right?
Right. More fun.
Oh, I need to tighten my strap. Forgot to drop my new helmet on the ground. I don't know, do they do that in mountain biking? My helmet's too loose. It's going over my eyes. Good?
Yeah. Sorry, we're trying to get away. You're taking the left line?
Huh? Yeah.
The left line right here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want me to just get out of
it? Yeah, no problem. Oh, no worries at all. Have a good one.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, it sucked. Peace.